Good morning, friends.
Good morning.
Once again, loud good morning, friend.
Good morning.
I wish you warm welcome to our YouTube channel. In case if you are not subscribed our YouTube channel, you can subscribe and press the bell icon to receive the regular update. Today, we are on 12th July 2019 and we are conducting our fourth batch, Be a HNI NRI Portfolio Planner. Okay, and I am happy that we have four participants with us and we have successfully completed two full day learning workshop, and we have one new participant with us because three participants, Shrey, Tanna, Shraddha and Ankit, they have already attended the various training, and out of three, two participants have already completed CFP and they are basically attending the value-added learning workshop with me. Shraddha, she has already completed her video learning training, and now she also apparently pursuing the CFA level 1. So we have a Sanjay ji with us. So what, Sanjay ji, we can start with you. You can start with your introduction, qualification, work experience, your achievements. So we can divide our video into two part. One is about your journey from a LIC agent to a till date 2019, and now you have attended this training and completed two full day. So what would be the next level in your professional career? And I'll be interacting with you.
Okay. Yeah. So hi everybody.
Yes. Good morning.
Good morning. I'm Sanjay. And I started my financial planning and advisory business as an insurance advisor in 2002. And this is my second generation, and my father was already doing it. So I took it from my father and I started building on that. From 2002, it was a very good journey. It was a very high time for insurance advisory and market was very good. So I spent around 7-8 years in that. And later on, I shifted towards a job in Max York Life. Mm. But that was a very, very small stint because I wanted to grow and I wanted to see how things are developing.
Okay.
So in that journey, but that was a very small stint. I again came back to my this insurance advisory business. Mm. And then in 2015, I took a call and then I shifted my business only from life insurance advisory to a complete wealth management type of an advisory business. In that business, we only concentrated on mutual fund.
Perfect.
But moving into the market, seeing the how the trends are going and the way our clients are, we generally deal with clients at upper level where they want to have more options.
Okay.
So apart from life insurance and mutual fund,
mm.
I wanted to give them more options for advisory and the right knowledge also.
Okay.
Our first take is to educate the clients.
Okay.
So clients generally are not very, very interactive when it comes to sharing the details, what they want. The only thing we find definitely two types of clients in our working life. Either one is so risk averse that he doesn't want to take any risk.
Okay.
I don't want any risk, no risk, no risk, no risk.
Mm.
And they are generally parting their money or parking their money in bank fixed deposits.
Okay.
They are that risk averse.
Mm.
Second category is they only want returns.
Okay.
Irrespective of what is happening, irrespective of where you are going, what is going, their only objective is to chase the returns.
Mm.
And when we find these two categories, so it is what I feel was that my job was to create and to manage returns.
Mm.
In this training, in the last 2 days, this is my realization that chasing returns or getting returns is not the role of a financial advisor.
Perfect.
Our role is to handhold the client like a doctor does.
Perfect.
That this is your illness. This is your course of action you should take to get out of that illness.
Perfect.
And then you have to take this medication.
Mm.
Whether it runs for 5 days or it runs for 1 year, you have to follow the doctor.
Mm.
So here after 2 days, I can realize that, that this is the right way of doing the things. One of major realizations which I got in 2 days was, like, I always consider debt has to be very, very risk-free, and that doesn't come with a risk. But yesterday, what we did was, and what we see was that is equally or more risky than equity. In equity, we understand the risk that I always understand the risk that I am taking that risk. I am going for the ownership.
Perfect.
Profit will be profit, loss will be loss. But under that, we have this conception in mind, concept in mind that it is risk-free. Isme mujhe risk nahi hoga, but it is risky. And it comes with various type of risk. It can be credit risk or it can be default risk. Importance of having a portfolio planner, which I understood was you get a second opinion type of a solution where somebody is advising you on something, but you can definitely have a second opinion on that.
Perfect.
How you are doing, how well, this is like having a consultant for doing that. So all these approaches makes one's money more efficient, I will say. We are not chasing returns at all. But that will not be the core objective.
Definitely.
Core objective will be the preservation of capital first.
Yes.
And then going for the returns. So various things which we learn, I found it very, very interesting.
Good. So thank you, Sanjay. So if I summarize for benefit of Sanjay's client, okay. So Sanjay communicate three important key learning. So when he will share this video with you, okay, so what you can get the key benefit from other normal distributor, okay. So first key learning was that he transformed in a first part from LIC agent to a mutual fund distributor, okay. So that is a normal progression for any advisor, those who have started career 10-15 years before, because LIC has a limited you can say return. Because when you invest in traditional endowment plan, it may not give you more than 5-6%. And for a short term or medium term need, you cannot give the LIC endowment plan because minimum term start with 10 years. So natural progression for the any LIC good distributor is to move to the mutual fund also, where you can cater all three need. For short term need, you can give a liquid fund or debt fund. Medium term, you need, you can give a combination. Okay, so it is not necessary you need to sell a dynamic asset allocation product or you have to sell balanced fund, but you can make a combination of equity and debt and suggest the particular 2-3 scheme. So the average return can be generated between 9-10%, and for long term need, client is understand the risk, okay, and potential return. So we can give a 80-90% into equity mutual fund. So that was the first progression. Now what he said specifically when he attended this 3-full-day workshop. So one important key learning, okay, so he said that and everyone has a same problem, you will find the extreme only. One extreme says that I want no risk, so I am a completely risk averse, I invest into fixed deposit, gold or real estate. Seconds will say I want maximum risk, so he may not even like to invest in mutual fund, he may like to go for the intraday fund or speculation, etc. So what is our objective as a financial planner or portfolio manager is to basically keep it into the middle. Quick risk averse hai to bhi usko hum educate karke kahan pe leke aaye, middle mein. Koi speculative hai to bhi kahan pe leke aaye, middle mein. And we suggest the right course of action, as he rightly said. So client can diversify portfolio as per the need, achieve their wealth creation or wealth preservation goal. So that is the first. Second, he talked about that debt mutual fund. So normally in good time we say that debt mutual fund are having only interest rate risk, but in bad times we realize since last 1 year debt mutual fund has also a credit risk or default risk. So if you chase return in a debt mutual fund, okay, where you say that this mutual fund having, yesterday when we discussed, some of the mutual fund having the debt product having a yield of more than 10%, so indirectly their underlying instrument are weak, so that's why it is a more than 10%. So we have said we should not go for any schemes where having a yield is more than 10%, which is expected provided that default money will come. Okay, so that is the second. Third, I forgot what you said about last aapne mujhe ek acha bola tha, mujhe bhi nahi yaad aa raha hai. So message is very simple, now when you meet Sanjay ji, he'll act as a portfolio planner, okay, and help you to construct the diversified portfolio to either yes, now I recollect it. He talked about that our objective is not to chase the return. Our objective is not to chase the return. Our objective is to basically either wealth creation or wealth preservation. So he will be able to help you to achieve the concept, whether your concept is to have a wealth preservation where you want post-tax, post-inflation, zero return, or maybe post-tax, post-inflation, in a longer term you want 3-4% real rate of return. So that can help you to you. Okay, good, very good. So now, when I say that you have completed two full day and tomorrow onward you will start meeting the many of your existing and potential client, so what would be the change in your approach? How you will be start in discussing from current approach to a new approach?
Yeah, that's very interesting. Generally, because I'm coming from north side of India, and where real estate is taken as a the perfect thing for investment. And people are generally invested, let's say 90%, 95% on real estate. And the crisis which they get into was, they get into liquidity crisis, because you cannot come out of the real estate.
Okay.
And
okay.
What they really understand is that real estate is the only thing which can only be increasing all the time.
Okay.
So my take will be, it has to be, real estate has to be part of your portfolio, but to some extent.
Okay.
10%, 15%, not more than that, because you need all aspects of an investment in while you are putting your money somewhere. If it has to be real estate, it has to be a reasonable. Real estate doesn't mean the house you are living in. The real estate, by investing in real estate, we mean where you are putting money to have a rental income or the capital appreciation. So, for North India, where financial assets literacy is very low and people don't consider them as the thing, because for the reason being, they consult the wrong people generally. They consult their friends, they consult some RMs, and then they make up their mind that this is risky and this is not risky. So this is one part. Another alternative investments which we found was like going into invest private equity types things, if somebody has that type of a
risk capital.
Otherwise, not chasing the returns, getting a very, very realistic approach, 12% type of a return in long run, gives you the peace of mind. And my approach will be that returns will come in the market, irrespective of whatever we do. But if our allocation is right, if our time horizon is well defined, we can have that anyhow.
Good, very good. So, he has also said one thing which I like, it is like a second opinion, because many of time HNI, NRI client, those who are having the high net worth or you can say high income, maybe crore rupees per annum in their active age, okay, they tend to make a lot of investment mistakes, because of many of time as a financial planner, we don't have access to them, normal condition, okay, suppose. Or they may not like to watch the, some of the videos and basically upgrade their financial literacy. That I have observed that, example, in Mumbai, there are thousands TV stars and film stars are there. Let's say 1,000. Nobody has watched the, some of the videos and called the financial planner. Like, I want to meet. Because they thought that, mere paas jo aata hai, okay, usi se mujhe investment karwa dena hai. So that is a wrong approach. So many of time when someone has a access of you, okay, HNI, another investor, and that someone who is your friend, relative, some of the known people, and they may sell products, okay, and or one of the biggest problem is the private banks, because each HNI or NRI client has their business account or their personal accounts with the private or corporate bank, or they may have access to wealth management company. And we have seen in our country 90% of time that private bank or wealth management company, their employee has a revenue generation target. So they have hired the experienced wealth manager and given a salary of 20-25 lakh rupees per annum, and they expect that you generate the net profit and get revenue for bank or wealth management 1 crore. Now if they have to generate a 1 crore revenue and average commission income is 10%, even though they have to sell the 10 crore rupees investment product, so then they will start looking, if I sell a example one exotic structured product or alternative investment fund, real estate, or maybe some private equity, my revenue will be 10%. So ticket size 1 crore, I'll say this is a exotic product, exclusive for HNI, exclusive for NRI, you invest and I created 10 lakh rupees revenue for me. So for me as a wealth manager, first to achieve my target, it is very easy because ticket size itself starting with PMS 25 lakh and AIF is 1 crore. Secondly, more I sell, I get more incentive and bonus, okay? I'll not name the company, but many of CEO of the investment company, they are in my LinkedIn group, okay, LinkedIn connection. And every 3 months, 6 months, one CEO of sharing that we have given our RM, wealth RM, 2 month bonus, 2 month salary as a bonus. Now this year we are celebrating our annual meeting in some foreign locations. Now, on a whose money? Please understand, we have to educate it at NHNI and NRI client ki if your wealth advisor, okay, is living an exorbitant lifestyle like you, it means that ke you are partly funding that lifestyle. And even sometimes it is a reverse, that HNI vyakti ek the moderate lifestyle jeeta hai aur uska advisor jo exorbitant deta hai, iska matlab aap hi apna paisa se uski lifestyle ko funding kar rahe hai. ओके वो कॉर्पोरेट हो सकता है, इंडिपेंडेंट भी हो सकता है. तो यू टू बी चूज वेरी चूजी टू सिलेक्ट द राइट फाइनेंशियल राइट पोर्टफोलियो एडवाइजर, सो विच कैन फर्स्ट बी ऑनेस्ट विथ यू, फर्स्ट बी योर रिप्रेजेंटेटिव एंड हेल्प यू टू अचीव योर लाइफ एस्पिरेशंस और लाइफ गोल एंड क्रिएट अ वेल्थ फॉर यू और बेसिकली हेल्प यू टू ट्रांसफर द वेल्थ फॉर द नेक्स्ट जनरेशन. ओके सो हियर Sanjay ji has initiated his learning journey with me with help of the Be a Portfolio Planner to HNI NRI investors, and we have a unique concept of partnership also. So definitely Sanjay ji will share this video to his prospective participant. I request you can meet first, okay, and he will suggest the two kind of business model. One is the what you have traditional distribution business model, and if you want to go ahead about the fee only model, okay, there I can come into picture, okay, and where we will construct the diversified portfolio, okay, and charge the fixed fee for that. Okay, so thank you very much Sanjay for sharing your valuable you can say your input about your journey from LIC agent to a mutual fund distributor, and now your second version of from the mutual fund distributor or independent financial advisor to a you can say portfolio planner. So thank you very much.
Thanks.